Bring in the shampoo now. Thank you. Shampoo?
Yeah.
What is shampoo?
That's a shampoo.
Champagne, sir.
Ah, lovely.
Oh, champagne?
Thank you, Rodney.
The Nouveau Rich call it shampoo.
The Nouveau Rich?
Yeah.
I think I've ruined the glasses.
No, that's quite all right.
I'm just going to sink it. I don't believe this. I mean, David, do you get tired of this lifestyle at all? I mean, you've been living it for quite some time.
Oh, it's bloody murder, mate.
Really?
Ugh, it's terrible.
You're a bit flash, actually, when it comes to it, aren't you?
Flash?
Yeah.
Oh, come on.
No, I mean, I'm as
a flying mallet. I wouldn't say that I'm flash. No, I'll tell you, when I gave up the business about 8 years ago, I was living around security guards, and I had a whole entourage that was with me at all times, and I was literally a prisoner of my own success, and I couldn't go out anywhere. People couldn't relate to me. They related to David Cassidy, the image that they had.
You quit the music biz, as it were, and now you're back and the charm is still there.
Well, I'm not so sure if the charm is still there.
That's what I read anyway.
Where the hell did you read that?
Well, some rotten magazine.
I tell you, it's wonderful to have been away for as long as I've been away and to come back with the first record that I made, Last Kiss, to have gone in the top five and to have been as successful as it was.
There were times all along that I thought I was catching on.
Also, there is an awareness about the music business in Britain that there is nowhere else in the world. I mean, every geezer you meet out on the street, every cab driver and every young guy is in a band and is playing, and they all have an awareness. I got into a cab the other day, and he says, "Hey, your new record, number five, huh?" And I said, "You know, you can't go anywhere without people knowing that you about your successes or your failures." Unfortunately, this time we're talking about successes. So the songs on this album are really about letting one's heart go and about getting back into the human experience over the past 8 years, about coming out of the darkness for me. And I know it's the best work I've ever done, and I think they're the best songs I've ever written. And Alan Carney did a great job. He understood who I was as an artist, I think, very well.
She danced into my life one night. Romance across a crowded room. She looked so right, and suddenly the whole world just stood still. As I reached to ask her for her hand, she offered me
question, I must ask. You're known as a bit of a romantic. Mm. When you think of David Cassidy, you think of love songs. Mm. Are you a romantic?
Well, the definition of romance is a little bigger than life. And I would say, yes, I am. The essence of pure romance, of the dark side of romance, the sensual side of romance, the sexual side of romance, and the lighter side of romance. So yeah, I would have to say I am.
In other words, you get the women. I'm going to jump in, mate. I can't handle this. Yeah! Oh,
listen,
God, listen,
hey?
Here. I love it. Hang on, do the old necktie up.
Yeah, see you in this. Cheers, mate.
Of course. Cheers to you. Oh, and
cheers.
To you. God, I love America. I love England. Do you?
Yeah.